some type of underground river that bubbled its pure, clean water 24 hours a day, which made the ancient armies of antiquity, it made it almost impossible for them to capture the city.
You go into that room, and I stand here at that glass. explained something to me. He said, this is my life. I pride myself in being the best in my business. I said, what do you want to do? He said, how do you do it? I said, do what? He said, I can't figure it out. I said, figure out what?
Nothing else after that.
He said, what's your secret?
He didn't even.
He said, I passed the screen, and one moment you're crying, and the next moment you're laughing. How do you do it? He said, if I could do that, he said, I could make $100 million. I turned to him and I said, sir, and $100 million couldn't buy it. Because what you're seeing is not personality, it's not talent, it's not chicanery, it's not emotion, it is the spirit of all.
Seven.
this far. You never dreamed you would get in this place. But my God, right now you keep standing. Your life is a nightmare. You go to sleep at night wondering where you're going to get your next fix. Needle tracks are all over your arms. You're living the life of a walking dead. It's dead and lame for you. It started out that way, but that's the way it always is. Others of you here, others of you watching the television, it started out late with you drinking quietly on the side, and then you couldn't wait for your husband to leave to go to work so you could get that bottle where you had hidden it. Bondage. And now you stagger and stumble. I can go on and on and on. I don't know about South Africa, but in the United States, there are between 10 and 12 million alcoholics. 7 and 8 million problem drinkers, making a total of nearly 20 million alcoholics. I'm sure South Africa is plagued with this problem as well. Satan has an array of forces geared to put you in bondage, and he is succeeding today at an unprecedented rate. Until your life knows no freedom, and I want to make this statement. I don't care who you are. You see, this is the age that we call the age of free living. I'll do what I want to do. I'll have my way. I'll go where I want to go, especially among the young people. Free. Let me tell you, without Jesus Christ, you don't know what freedom is.
No.
You can't know what freedom is. I don't care who you are. I don't care. You may think I'll do what I want to do. I'll live like I want to live. I'm free. You are a perfect target for the powers of death. Satan wants to destroy you. And he has smoothed that road out. And you feel like I can do it and I can beat the game, but no one ever has.
Well,
tell you something. The devil laughs at that foolishness.
Or
if you
may be a religious man or woman, is the power of Almighty God. The power of Almighty God. While I was kneeling there, the Spirit of God came upon me. I saw a vision of heaven. I saw demons black as midnight, writhing like snakes by the thousands beneath the cross. I saw them writhing and rolling and turning and all of their heads demonic power. Then my vision switched to the hands of my master, nailed to that flame tree. And from those hands was dripping blood.
Girl, is that true?
And when that blood would fall and hit those demons, they would scream and roll back. Their screams pierced the air as that blood hit them and it sounded like grease and a hot skin. And I told this man what I'd seen. I said, right now, if you'll say yes to Jesus, this moment has power. Can break the bondage of drugs. He can break it instantly if you'll just give him a chance right now.
This is a guy who's one of the greatest kings that you've
this deal option on Commander-in-Chief, Brad Schiffer, to take the city of Jerusalem. Brad Schiffer draws up his mind, almost as far as the eye can see outside the walls of Jerusalem. Black legions that have never come to him. Men of war that lived and breathed the conqueror wars. Jerusalem was threatened. They would rule over this city like you ruled over a war great and see its worth. Red Ship, commander of the islands of Sir Edward, ruler of the whole earth, stand for the Bylon Spring of the Lord here, and the standing of the one territory. He looked at Jerusalem and he cursed him. He said, that's your God. That's your God, said you.
Jesus Christ, and then called If you hold on to this book, God will stand by your side, because this is your strength. This is your
power. That's what it is.
He'd been the number one most wanted criminal in the state of California. He'd been with the Hell's Angels for nearly 20 years. It was mean. His life was drunkenness, illicit sex, filth, perversion, rot, drug addiction, robbing banks. When the judge sentenced him, she said, "You will never get out of jail. You will rot there. You're a dead man." When they finally caught him, product of a broken home. Never been to church. Never knew God. And sitting there that Sunday morning in that whole solitary confinement, hell on earth, no clothing on his body, you pardon my crudeness, naked. His heart beating out of his chest. He would have killed for a little white powder. He was in solitary confinement for trying to kill him. The state of California had given the orders that people that were placed, men that were placed in solitary confinement, they had to have a television set placed outside the bar so that maybe they could see something to keep them from going crazy. Locked up in the office. 8 o'clock that Sunday morning, our telecast came in. For the first time in his life, he turned and looked at him. God, even though the program was going out to millions, timed the words perfectly because God knew where it was going. And he said, "Jimmy Swaggart, you pointed your finger at that TV screen and said, 'Sir, you're on drugs and you're bad. And you can't stand it anymore, but Jesus Christ can set you free.'" He said, "Brother Swaggart, something went all over me. Never prayed in his life. Dropped on his knees. This sounds like a fairy tale, but it happened because God can make it." He said, "Lord, if you exist, come into my heart. Come into my life. Break the bonds of drugs. Take away the craving. If you'll do it, I'll live free. I've made a good soldier for those bad times. And if you're really there, and you really have what they say you have, and what the preacher said you have, break these bonds. And I'll live just as strong for you as I did for them." He said, "Jimmy Swaggart, I have shot up," he said. He said he'd shot up with heroin. Mainline. "I don't know. I don't guess I've ever taken any type of mind-altering drug in my life, much less something like that. But I've read that for a few moments, the high that that thing gives you is like nothing else, as far as the world is concerned. But," he said, "Jimmy Swaggart, I sensed a power that was greater than all the power of drugs." The ironical thing about it, about 10 minutes later, a guard came into the room and rang his bell and secreted in the meal was a little cellophane full of drugs. The guard was smuggling into it. He took it. 15 minutes ago, he would have given anything he had for it. independent guards have taken. I don't want it. I don't need it. I'll never need it again. Miracle of miracles, he's out of prison today. He's preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. He would never look at it before if he lived a life he lived.
Come on,
Jesus. Said it.
Lord Jesus, thank you.
I don't care how bad off you may be. He can set you free. I don't care how well off you may be. He can set you free. Well, you're dead.
Got enough of the misery.
Let
it keep being seen openly, Lord.
Listen,
and give them more and thank you.
Jimmy Swaggart, I'm not living right. I need the power of God in my heart and in my life. I need something stronger than I am, than I have. Would you pray for me? How many will slip up their hand? Embarrass you, I promise that. All over this world, all the way around, just slip it up. Slip it up. I'm not living right, Brother Swagger. I need prayer. Would you pray for me? I don't care who you are, church member, not a church member, whatever you may be, but I'm not living right. Pray for me. Slip it up. Slip it up. Thank you. Thank you so much. I want everyone to stand. Everybody stand. Everybody stand.
Never been short of faith.
I would ask every one of you
raised
your hand. I'm going to ask you to walk down here and stand. I want to pray with you. I want you to come. I want you to come. We'll wait on you wherever you are. I want you to step down. Come from the sides, the back, wherever you are. And stand right down here. As they sing it, I want you to come. us what you please for just a moment. Those of you on television, I want you to listen as well for just a moment. God loves every one of you. I want you to understand. I mean every one of you. I want you to think about that just a moment. Each of you standing here, you're special at this side. He loves you supremely. He wants you to walk holy before him. He'll give you the power to do it. The scripture says, to whom the Son sets free is free indeed. I don't know exactly what you need, all of you, but God knows. And I'm going to pray the sinner's prayer right now. It'll be a simple word, and I want you to repeat it after me. I want you to believe it with all of your heart, and I want you to open up your heart to God. Whatever you have needed, meet business with him. Be sincere. Or would you bow your head and please close your eyes? Let's pray. Dear God, I come to you in Jesus' name. I'm tired of the old life. I want your life, your way, and your mercy.
He's gone for us through this particular moment. All four of these commentaries for $70. Now you heard me right, $70 for the commentaries of Matthew, Mark, and John. You need to run to that phone. You need to go online and take advantage of this very special gospel commentary offer right now. Don't delay.
Family Worship Center pastors as they minister in a city near you.
Thank you. Turn to walls. From the rough to the wall.
Constitution now in place. Its new government was up and running. But how would the nation develop? What would be its destiny? The Constitution of the United States was constructed on the firmly laid foundation of the Declaration of Independence. The preamble of the Constitution concisely adopted the principles of the Declaration and adapted those principles to build a structured form of government, a representative republic. This young republic would represent the moral fortitude of its founders and the spiritual values of its people. It would be evident that this new form of government was built on the bedrock of biblical principles. The American national consciousness, one observer wrote, is not a voice crying out of the depth of a dark past, but is proudly a product of the enlightened present, setting its face resolutely toward the future. American exceptionalism was the embodiment of a stirring ideal. Since the arrival of the Pilgrims, many thought of America as a chosen vessel for a special role in God's great plan, as the Constitution put it, to ensure the blessing of liberty. Pastor Jonathan Edwards said, God chose America as the glorious renovator of the world. John Adams proclaimed the opening of America as a grand scheme and design in providence for the illumination and the emancipation of the slavish part of mankind all over the earth. This mission Adams spoke of was the call to lead the world for a greater liberty. But there were problems that still needed address. Before the Revolutionary War, colonists knew only struggles. The struggle to survive, the struggle to overcome oppression, the struggle to break away from the bonds of tyranny. But having accomplished the unimaginable in victory over the British, citizens now found themselves in their own country living in peace. With men like Thomas Jefferson, George Washington, and John Adams laying the foundation for a growing nation to stand upon, how could anything go wrong? Nothing born of God can remain untested. There are great trials on the horizon for the young American. At the dawn of the 19th century, people's activities began to drift in different